Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Firefighters from two states were called into Keene early this morning for a four-alarm fire. Look at this right here. As firefighters raced to the scene, there were reports that people were trapped inside. Eventually, it was determined everybody made it out. And firefighters are crediting some good Samaritans for coming to the residents' aid. Ray Brewer has the story.
When they first arrived, they had a fire showing on the third floor in one of the dormers.
This home video shows what firefighters were dealing with at 54 Pine Street in Keene. The fire was reported around 1:45 in the morning. Sam Dodson, who lives in the neighborhood, was just getting home.
Smelled the smoke from the neighborhood, went over there and saw the flames coming out of the roof.
The fire chief says at first they thought there might be people trapped inside. Firefighters searched the first and second floors, but couldn't reach the third floor because the fire was too intense.
At that point, there was still an indication that there was people in the building. Shortly thereafter, we did confirm that the occupants on the third floor were not there.
At the time of the fire, there were three people home. One of them was the apartment house owner, Andrew Hayes. While too upset to go on camera, Hayes says he was awoken by someone pounding on his door. The fire eventually went to four alarms. Even firefighters from Vermont were called in. The chief says the weather didn't help.
The amount of heat and humidity that's out here, the firefighters are getting worn out pretty quick.
Neighbors say they were not concerned about the fire spreading, but it was tough to deal with all the smoke.
You could hear crackling, and at one point after it had been going for a while, you could feel it in your eyes.
Despite firefighters' best efforts, the damage was extensive.
We had about 4,000 to 5,000 gallons of water each minute going into the building, so it's probably a total loss.
So far, no cause has been found. The three residents have found other places to stay. A Laconia man, once charged with negligent homicide, was back in court today facing new charges related to driving. 30-year-old Joshua Shepard pled not guilty to driving with a suspended license. Guilford police pulled Shepard over last month after they got a call that he was driving his motorcycle erratically. Police say they also found prescription drugs on him that weren't his. Now, he's the same man who was convicted in 2006 of killing three motorcyclists during Motorcycle Week. That conviction was later overturned by the state's Supreme Court. A man suffered serious injuries after falling 60 feet near a waterfall in the White Mountain National Forest. Fish and game officials say 24-year-old Devin Arn of Twin Mountain was hiking alone yesterday when he lost his footing. Five camp counselors saw the fall and saved him from a second waterfall. Other volunteers set up a pulley system to get him off the mountain. Arn was airlifted to Maine Medical Center, where he is listed in serious condition. And a car had to be towed out of the Powwow Pond in Kingston after a driver drove right into the water. Emergency officials say the driver was able to make it to shore. They believe he missed a turn and drove right down the boat ramp. It's unclear what caused the driver to veer into that pond. Starting tonight at 5, a Connecticut power plant now facing a massive fine for a deadly explosion that killed six people, including a New Hampshire man. And the post office facing even bigger monetary losses if five-day delivery weeks could soon become a reality to cut back on costs. We'll let you know. That does it for us. Have a great Thursday afternoon, everybody.